and I are at Blue Springs Park in Florida, and Thomas is out there swimming in the fresh water. This thing's about 72 degrees all year round. It's where a lot of the manatees come and hang out in the wintertime because it's warm. But we're going to go on a boat ride a little bit later, and we'll show you more stuff then.
Hey. Tell me that it's okay now. What are you want? You never got my dreams, got my life, got my love, got my friends, got the sunshine above. Why am I making this hard on myself when there's so many beautiful reasons I have to be happy?
So it's important they get out and dry their feathers. They could actually become waterlogged and never reach the top again. And when you get the tannins, kept the scum growth down so the water stayed drinkable for longer periods of time. This is big. He's at least 12 feet.
Oh, I see, I see.
Oh, yeah.
Tell us anything about what we've seen?
We saw some manatees a while back.
And what was that big gator thing?
It was a big alligator, and they called it Tick.
Right.
Because it got ticked off. We've been seeing a lot of herons and blackbirds, and I keep forgetting what they're called.
What's your point, Ned, up here?
And some small herons, great herons.
And turtles.
Yeah, and turtles.
Oh, fish.
See him, Thomas?
Yeah, Phyllis being bothered by two males, and that's, well, except that she has two calves, and I don't know who the other manatee is. Look at that, look.
What are all the scars from?
From the propeller. See that zipper scar? That's definitely a propeller. She's got,
look at him. Look,
she's got two calves, an older calf and a new calf, and then I don't know who the third manatee is.
Wow.
See your new calf right next to her?
Come here, look!
From the propeller. See that zipper scar? That's definitely a propeller.
Oh.
She's got
She's got two calves, an older calf and a new calf, and then I don't know who the third is.
Guess what, I'm there.
Good eye.
Four of them there.
Look at that.
I just got the big one here.
Big girl. Look at her.
Going in the water.
She is. She's coming in.
Getting ready to lay those eggs. She should have already laid them, though. It's July. It's half over. Well, this was, I tell you what, this is one of the later nests built, too. This nest wasn't finished till about the end of June. I mean, really the end of June. So I wouldn't be surprised if those eggs didn't catch up.
Yeah. Did you get a picture of them?
I got it.
Can't figure how I'm gonna fix tomorrow when yesterday's still a mess. Can you tell me what's the point, man? It all seems meaningless. I wish that I could step away and breathe. This world's trying to swallow me. Clear away the clouds inside my head. Someone just tell me that it's okay now. What are you worrying about? Got my dreams, got my life, got my love. Got my friends, got the sunshine above. Why am I making this hard on myself when there's so many beautiful reasons I have to be happy? People lie, people hide, people cry, people fight, and they don't know why. If fear is all that we should fear, then what are we so afraid of? 'Cause fear is only in our heads. Someone please say that it's okay now. What are you worrying about? What are you worrying about? Got my dreams, got my life, got my love. Got my friends, got the sunshine above. Why am I making this hard on myself when there's so many beautiful reasons I have to be?
Enjoying the tour?
Fabulous.
It's really cool.
It's really neat seeing all this wildlife and vegetation.
It's beautiful, and the lady's been really helpful. A lot of good information.
Yeah.
It's beautiful to know that this still exists out here in this world. We're coming into some weather. You see that? It's kind of like perhaps lightning.
A change in the weather.
My friends got the sunshine above. Why am I making this hard on myself when there's so many beautiful reasons I have to be happy?
Now you know how to crack the claws and everything?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright. We just had a class this morning. I had to show everybody that works here how to do that.
Oh.
I like to hyperextend the arms.
So we'll talk about your... What do you got here?
I got a lobster.
Yep. Full lobster. You gonna eat it all?
No.
Well, where do you start off?
We'll come back later. Jason's got
Aztec chicken.
Very good. And I have potato, and I have some flounder.
Can't do without the wonderful Red Lobster biscuits.
That's right, because we are at the fabulous Red Lobster.
It's my bathing suit on.
But you're not gonna. Don't break that, because I want to eat it. If you're not gonna eat it, I'm gonna take it home.
Oh, he's going to smell like lobster.
How much lobster did you actually eat?
One a
claw.
I filled up on, like, chips and biscuits.
How are we doing over here?
You know, I think he's going to make me box that up and eat it when I go home.
You want me to pull the meat out for you?
No, because I want to pull meat out when I get home, because he's just going to play with it.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here at this Red Lobster to say farewell to our lobster friend, who didn't even get eaten. Goodbye, lobster. Do you have anything to say about your lobster before?
He tasted good.
Did he? Was he a friend of yours? Will you miss him?